السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، ما بعد. Today I wanted to speak about a minhaj in regards to how to read and study books. The scholars, they mentioned a nice qaida, a nice principle, that an individual should read the same book multiple times before going on to another book, and I'm going to explain. مثلا, you have this book here, النحو الصغير, written by Sheikh Sulaiman Al-Uyuni, hafidhahu Allah ta'ala, from the scholars of the Arabic language here in Saudi Arabia, and I believe in Riyadh. Allahumma barak, he's an amazing Sheikh. I definitely advise the people to listen to his shuruhat of particular books. He's an amazing scholar of the Arabic language. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. He even mentions himself, and I don't think it's his kalam. It's something that's known even before his time, hafidhahu Allah ta'ala. He said, it's more beloved to me that I read the same book, ثلاث مرات, three times, rather than I read three different books, meaning in the same topic, in the same subject, in the same fen. So instance, you have this book here, نحو الصغير. It's a book on Arabic grammar. It's better, it's more beneficial that I read this book three times, four times, five times, then I read this book one time, then I read another book, and then another book, and another book on the same topic, on the same level. Both, beginner books. Does that make sense? We're not talking about you read a book on grammar, and then you read a book on hadith, a book on aqidah, that's fine. But in the same fen, in the same science, here we're speaking about Arabic grammar, it's better that I read this book multiple times before going on to another book in Arabic grammar, even if that book is on the same level. We're not even talking about a book on a higher level. Of course, you definitely shouldn't go to that until you master this. But even books, if they're on the same level. So you have this book here, Nahu Saghir. Then you have another book that is on the same level. It's called Nahu Al-Wadih. Nahu Al-Wadih. These books are on the same level, even though Nahu Al-Wadih is actually going to be much bigger because it just has more examples. But it's really the same. It's for Mubtadi'een. It's for beginners. It's better that I read this book three, four, five times, even before going on to that book. Why? Because every mu'allif, every author, he has his own minhaj, his own tariq, his own way of writing and explaining his book. So it's better that I understand the mustalahat, that I understand the tariq, the way that this sheikh explained this book, then I read this book one time, then I go to another book, and maybe I'm confused. But wait, why am I confused? They're the same, it's the same thing, it's the same level. It's because that scholar has a different way that he wrote his book. So you're going to be kind of confused. So it's better that an individual gets a book, مثلا ثلاث الرسول, he reads that book three, four, five times, and then he goes on to another book. You don't go read this book one time, then you put it down, then you go to another book, then another book. No. Choose a book, read that book over and over and over again until, in reality, until you master the book, but أقل, the minimum, three times, and then move on to another book in the same topic. And this is just a nice fa'idah in regards to reading books. This way you get good tasawwur, you get good understanding and a good overall grasp of the content that is in the book. Because you find people, one minute they're on this, then they put it down and they go to another book. They're not even finishing the book one time. You realize that they read 10 books, not really 10 books, but they read parts of 10 different books. And if you ask them, explain one of them to me, they really can't do it. So it's better and it's more beneficial that the student, he chooses a book, he sticks with that book until he understands it. And then ينتقل إلى كتاب آخر. And then he goes to another book. ويسك الله سبحانه وتعالى that he gives us fiqh في الدين. اللهم آمين. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.